globally, every year, about 500,000 people lose use of their limbs due to spinal cord injury, both in terms of being able to move them and being able to feel sensations in their limbs. Brain-machine interfaces, or BMI, can help these people regain function of their limbs by using brain signals to directly control prosthetic or robotic limbs, thus bypassing the damaged spinal cord. Brain-machine interfaces work by reading signals directly from the brain through microelectrode arrays implanted in the hand representation area of the brain. These signals can then be decoded and used to move a robotic arm. Now, being able to control movement of a robotic arm to interact with everyday objects is just one part of the equation. Receiving sensory feedback when we grasp or manipulate an object is also extremely important. For example, when we pick up a glass of water to drink, we receive a lot of sensory information, including the shape, texture, and the weight of the glass. We use this information to plan smooth movements to bring the glass to our mouths. So being able to move the arm is not enough. We need to feel the sensations to complete even very simple movements. So my work is focused on incorporating this sensory feedback in brain-machine interfaces so that the robotic arm feels more like a native arm. We can do that by direct electrical stimulation of the area of the brain that represents the hands, thus bypassing the damaged spinal cord. This work was done in collaboration between the Department of Physical Medicine and Rehabilitation at Johns Hopkins and the Johns Hopkins Applied Physics Lab. Here, I'm going to focus on three studies. All these studies were done in a single participant who had limited function of his arm. This participant also had close to normal sensation in the hand and the fingertip region. The first study describes strategies to implant stimulation electrodes in the correct area of the brain. For example, if you want to grasp or manipulate an object, we need to provide sensory feedback to the fingers. So it is important to place the electrodes precisely in the area of the brain that has hand or fingertip representation. Only then can you achieve precise stimulation. Generally, finding the right areas of the hand is done through functional MRI done before the surgery. This study describes a novel online functional mapping strategy that is done during the microelectrode implantation surgery and that can potentially better localize fingertip areas in the somatosensory cortex. What was done here was during the surgery, the participant was woken up and a large, dense electrocorticography grid was placed on the cortex. Note that this was a much larger grid that covered a much larger area compared to the really tiny microelectrode arrays that would eventually be implanted. Due to the size, the grid was able to cover a larger area of the brain regions of interest. After placing the grid, each finger of the hand was stimulated through mechanical vibrations through motors placed on the finger. We then looked for electrodes on the grid that showed strong gamma activity whenever the fingers were mechanically stimulated. This electrode grid with the active electrodes was then overlaid on a picture of the brain surface. Based on where the active electrodes were situated on the picture of the brain surface, we were able to precisely find the locations to implant the microelectrode arrays and were able to get good representation of the fingers. This way, online functional mapping can be used for making sure that microelectrode arrays are implanted in the correct desired location of the brain so that we can provide precise sensory feedback in the form of brain stimulation. So now that we have implanted in the correct fingertip areas of the brain, in the second study, we investigated how long it takes between brain stimulation and when the participant perceives the sensation. This timing is very important. A natural mechanically evoked sensation when our fingers touch something, the sensation is almost instantaneous, which allows us to do dexterous manipulation of objects. Now imagine if there was half a second delay between when you grasp the object and when you sense the object, you'd barely be able to do any object manipulation that way. So the question here is, can we achieve similar instantaneous sensation when we electrically stimulate the brain? So here, the objective was to characterize when the brain stimulation-based sensation was consciously experienced, and to compare this timing to mechanically evoked counterpart in our participant. Note that we can do this experiment because the participant has almost normal intact sensation in his fingertips. What we found was very interesting, that brain stimulation evoked sensations that were slightly slower than the mechanically evoked sensations, but not by much. This result is very important because it shows that sensations evoked by brain stimulation is fast enough to be effective in brain-machine interfaces. So now that we know that electrical brain stimulation can be perceived at a fast enough timescale, the next question is, can we use this to help spinal cord injury patients to grasp objects in real life? So in the third study, the goal was to develop stimulation strategies that can enable patients to identify three different virtual objects based solely on the sensory feedback that is given through brain stimulation. Here, the participant cannot see or physically touch the object. All the information that they had was coming through sensory feedback through brain stimulation. The three virtual objects that we used in our study were a cylinder. The second object was a positive slope object, which was conical, which basically decreased in diameter in one direction, and a negative slope object, which was also conical, but it increased diameter in the opposite direction. The brain stimulation varied in time and space. In space, meaning for a cylinder that has the same diameter throughout, all fingers receive stimulation at the same time. For the positive and the negative slope objects, due to the nature of the object and how it was gripped, the timing of when the sensation was perceived between individual fingers differed. That is, some fingers got sensation slightly before the others. Stimulation was also varied, such that when grasp was initiated, stimulation intensity ramped up, but stayed constant after the grasp was completed and then gradually decreased as the object was let go. Based on this type of strategy, the participant was able to identify these three different objects more than 80% of the times. This is a very interesting and an important result because it shows that this kind of brain stimulation that varies in space and time due to the nature of the object is a viable option to provide sensory feedback that can help patients interact with objects in daily life. Taken together, these three studies show that brain stimulation given to the correct part of the hands can be used to give sensory feedback to spinal cord injury patients that can effectively enable these patients to dexterously manipulate objects in real life.